بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وآله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا أما بعد so tonight inshallah ta'ala we begin with Surah Al-Fatihah. So we're told that this chapter has seven verses and the meaning of its name Fatiha كل شيء أوله ومبتدأه. We're told that it is basically for everything that is the beginning and is at the forefront. وَالْجَمْعُ فواتح, the plural form is فواتح. And so we're told that سَبَبُ تَسْمِيَتِهَا, the reason why it has this name of الفاتحة, لِأَنَّهُ تُفْتَتَحُ بِكِتَابَتِهَا الْمَصَاحِفِ وَبِقِرَاءَتِهَا الصَّلَوَاتِ. The Shaykh tells us that the chapter is given this name because Allah Azza wa Jal begins the Qur'an, and every single Mus'haf begins with this chapter. So it is the opening chapter, the beginning chapter, the first chapter. And it is with this surah that we begin every one of our prayers. Asma'uha, what are some of the different names that it has? Ishtuhirat bi surat al-Fatiha. So it is famous through this name of al-Fatiha. وَتُسَمَّ سُورَةُ أُمِّ الْكِتَابِ. It is also known as أُمُّ الْكِتَابِ, the source, the mother of the book as a whole, so the essence of the book. وَسَبْعُ الْمَثَانِي, and the seven oft repeated. وَسُورَةُ الْحَمْدِ, and the chapter of praise and thanks. مَقَاصِدُهَا أو مَقْصِدُهَا الْعَامِ. What is the main objective of this chapter? تَوْحِيدُ اللَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ, focusing on Allah Ta'ala's uniqueness, His absolute oneness, وَتَعَذِيمُهُ, as well as exalting His mention, His praise, and all that He is, Subhana, وَالثَّنَاءَ عَلَيْهِ, also praising and thanking Him, Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, وَعِبَادَتُهُ, as well as worshipping Him and only Him, Jalla wa Ala, and the last thing that's mentioned is الدُّعَاءُ إِلَيْهِ, and that is calling upon Him in prayer, as well as calling to Him, Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, meaning that in da'wah, that we are calling people to Allahu Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. Sababu nuzuliha, the reason why this chapter was revealed. We're told that it is Suratun Makkiyah, meaning that it was pre-Hijrah, so it is a Meccan chapter. وَلَمْ تَصِحَّ رِوَايَةٌ فِي سَبَبِ نُزُولِهَا أَوْ فِي نُزُولِ بَعْضِ آيَاتِهَا. The Shaykh tells us that there is nothing that is authentic, that is legitimately authentic, that tells us that the chapter was revealed because of this specific purpose, or that even some of its verses were revealed because of a specific purpose. So we don't have anything specifically on that. However, with regards to fadluha, its virtues, we have several that are authentic that have been mentioned. The first is أنها أعظم سورة في القرآن, that it is the greatest chapter within the entire Qur'an. So understand that out of 114 chapters, not only is it the first in the Qur'an, but it is the first in the sense of rank. It is the greatest, it is the most important, subhanAllah. How do we know this? In a hadith that Imam al-Bukhari, rahmatullahi alayhi, that he collects, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to a man, قَالَ لِرَجُلٍ أَلَا أُعَلِّمُكَ أَعْظَمَ سُورَةٍ فِي الْقُرْآنِ, that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam said to one of the men who was with him, he said, how about I teach you the greatest chapter within the entire Qur'an? And the Prophet alayhi salatu wasallam then followed up with it saying, Alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen, meaning all praise and thanks are to Allah, this chapter here, which is Surah Al-Fatiha. A second virtue, hiya nur, that it is in and of itself, it is light. قال ملك للنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. We're told that an angel said to the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, and this narration is in Sahih Muslim. أبشر بنورين أوتيتهما لم يؤتهما نبي قبلك. The angel said to the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, behold, good news, glad tidings of two sources of light that you were given, that no prophet before you was given them. Fatihatul Kitab, he mentions the first, the beginning of the book, Surah Al-Fatiha, which is this chapter, of course. And then secondly, Khawatimu Surah Al-Baqarah, the ending of Surah Al-Baqarah, the last two verses of Surah Al-Baqarah, which is the second chapter. لَن تَقْرَأْ بِحَرْفِ مِنْهُمَا إِلَّا أُعْطِيتَهُ. The angel completed it saying that you will not recite even a word from it, except that you will be granted what you are asking for. And we know that, subhanAllah, Surah Al-Fatiha, as well as those two verses at the end of Al-Baqarah, are dua. And those are some of the most important du'as, and this is why we're supposed to be repeating them as often as we do. The third virtue for this chapter is hiya shifa. It is healing. It is a cure. It is medicine, spiritual medicine. And we have for this hadith what Imam al-Bukhari rahimahullah ta'ala collects, wherein he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, qala nabiyu alayhi salatu wa sallam li sahabiyyi raqi bil fatiha. So the Messenger alayhi salatu wa sallam said to the Sahabi who used this chapter as a healing for the particular person who was sick, who was bitten by a snake, and he recited Al-Fatiha on the person's who was bitten, the Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam said to that Sahabi, وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ أَنَّهَا رُقْيَةٌ. He says, and how did you know? How did you figure out? How did you know that it is a healing, that it is medicine? So this is among the virtues and blessings. The last point we have here is the context of the verses, the beginning of the chapter with the end of the chapter. فَقَالَ مُنَاسَبَاتُهَا مِنَ الْآيَةِ الْأُولَى إِلَى الْآيَةِ الْخَامِسَةِ. So from the first verse to the fifth, ثَنَاءٌ عَلَى اللَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ وَتَحْمِيدُ. That those first five verses are all praising and exalting the mention of Allah, Rabbul Alameen, who deserves all praise and thanks. ومن الآية السادسة إلى السابعة. The last two verses, دعاء بالهداية والاستقامة. That we are supplicating, asking Allah Ta'ala for guidance and uprightness, to remain steadfast upon righteousness. وفيها تعلق بالله تعالى. And what we are learning from this chapter is this sense of devotion, this adherence of devotion to Allah Rabbul Alameen wa mahabbatihi, and loving Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. Bitakrari qira'ati surati fi salawat. And we're manifesting this through our repeated reciting of this chapter in our prayers. Munasabat surat al-Fatihati lima ba'daha min suwar al-Qur'an al-Kareem. The relationship of Surah Al-Fatiha, we can't say to what came before it because it's the first, but to what comes after it. تُعَدُّ الْفَاتِحَةُ مُقَدِّمَةً مُجْمَلَةً لِأُصُولِ الْمَوْضُعَاتِ الْمُفَصَّلَةِ فِي سُورِ الْقُرْآنِ بَعْدَهَا. So the role that it has is that basically the Quran, the Surah Al-Fatiha is an introduction, a general introduction to all of the different subjects and the topics beneath them that will be addressed specifically throughout the remainder of the chapters in the Quran. Wallahu subhanahu wa ta'ala a'la wa a'lam wa sallallahu wa sallam wa baraka ala nabiyyina Muhammad.